whole lot of trouble. Pocoyo and Ellie and Pato.
Hi.
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Ellie out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Ellie, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Ellie, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh, my. You're balloons now. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it? It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off! Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. Mm-hmm. See you soon. House of Colors. Hi, Ellie. What are you doing? Painting? Of course! You're painting the house pink, a beautiful colour. Oh, yes, very beautiful. I mean, the most beautiful colour in the whole wide world. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi!
Ellie's still got quite a lot to paint. Maybe she could use some help. I think perhaps she'd love some help. Well, Ellie, you've certainly made a very pink house. What's up? There, a nice can of pink. Pato, I'm afraid Ellie's not happy with your colour. Insists you paint the house pink.
No, blue.
Pato's painted your portrait on the wall. But Ellie, it can't be that bad to paint with other colours. Ellie. not Pocoyo. Oh no, Pato. Guys, maybe you should... Easy now, guys. Wait a minute. If you don't calm down, you'll never solve this. What a mess. Good idea, Ellie. Each of you can paint a part. Wonderful! Coloring book. Hello, Pocoyo. What are you doing?
My book.
You're reading a book? What a great idea. Look, it has a red apple, a red car, a red ladybug, and a heart that is...
red.
Oh, look, and a red Pocoyo.
No, Pocoyo blue.
Are you sure? No, Pocoyo, it's yellow, like you.
Yellow! Ellie!
Hello, Ellie.
Ellie, yellow! Yellow light book.
Yes, Ellie. Pocoyo has a magic book, and when you turn the pages, everything changes color. What a great idea, Ellie. Let's find Pato.
Yes, Pato!
Hello, Pato.
Pato!
Perhaps we should explain to Pato that thanks to the book, everything will now be blue.
Blue.
Oh, you look like a blueberry with a beak. I think you should look at yourself in the mirror. But Pato, it's a lovely blue. Well, you're right there. A duck should be duck yellow. Or green. To be fair, it's a very pretty colour, don't you think? Oh dear. Ellie says it's her turn with the book.
No, my book.
Orange. What a lovely color for an elephant.
Mine. Purple.
I'm afraid Ellie and Pato are not very happy with that color. Guys, guys! But how many colors are there in that book?
My book! Gimp! Oops!
Oh dear, when you put the book away, the light went out. No, the colours have changed. Let's see, Pocoyo, can you think how to solve this? I meant by sharing the book.
No, my book.
Come on, Pocoyo. Just think. If you share the book, perhaps the colours will be fixed. Oh, maybe not. And here we go again. Finally! Look, Ellie, you're back to pink. Oh dear. The colours are all mixed up. You're right, Pato. It's about time to get your colour back. Ah, guys, you've lost your colour.
Colour?
Oh no, the whole book is blank. We'll never see Ellie's pink or Pato's yellow or the lovely blue of...
Idea!
Pocoyo, you've had an idea. Great idea, Pocoyo. But do you think it will work? Yes, it worked. It worked. Oh dear. Hooray for books and hooray for a colourful friendship. Goodbye. See you next time. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Ah, building blocks. How nice. What's this?
Friend.
You've made some new friends? And they're so colourful.
Day.
There's a blue one, and a yellow one, and a green one, and a red one.
Friends! Wait, Pato, wait!
I see. You're going to show Pato.
Friends?
Where did they go?
Professor Pato.
Hello, friends. Welcome to another lesson with Professor Pato. Professor Pato says that when there's sun and rain, something wonderful appears. A rainbow. How lovely.
Rainbow.
Well done, Caterpillar. Baby bird. Can you tell us what that's called? Can you help baby bird?
Rainbow!
It's a rainbow.
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say. Wonderful! Now we've all learned about rainbows.
Lesson approved by Professor Potter.
Still haven't found your friends, Pocoyo?
Daddy!
There's one. He's right there. Can you tell Pocoyo what colour to look for?
Yellow!
There's one. What colour is that one?
Blue!
It's blue!
Now what colour?
Green! The green one!
Now what colour should Pocoyo look for?
Red! The red one!
Bye, buddy!
Number menu.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 1 orange. Very good.
1 orange.
1 Oh dear. Well, how about 1 slice of watermelon instead?
1 slice of watermelon.
1 slice of watermelon. Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
1 heart.
That's it. 1. Look, Pato. These are Pocoyo's new friends.
Daddy, daddy.
Wonderful! What colourful friends you have, Pocoyo!
Red, blue, yellow, green. Color. You got the colors. Red.
Red.
Blue.
Blue.
Yellow.
Yellow.
Green.
Green.
Red.
Red.
Blue.
Blue.
Yellow.
Yellow.
Green.
Doesn't mean a thing. Alien is green and violent.
Ah, there's Pocoyo. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, what lovely toys and what lovely colours they are. What is it, Pocoyo? Do you see something else? Oh my goodness, what is that you found, Pocoyo? That looks interesting.
Buttons!
Yes, why not? Give it a go. Press a button. Let's see what happens. Look at that! Your train has turned red. Look at that! Oh, I wonder what is making the colours change. Do you know, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo? What do you think he's doing to make things change colour?
Pressing the buttons!
Yes, I think you're right. When Pocoyo presses the buttons on that toy, the colours change. Ooh, try pressing a different button, Pocoyo. Yes, it is the toy. It changes the colours of things. Amazing. All the blocks have turned red.
Yay!
And a new colour for the radio. Wow! Careful, Pato. Oh dear. Pocoyo? 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 Are you having fun changing colours? Yes. And do you think everyone else is having fun too? Really? Would you like to turn things back to normal, Pocoyo? Well, I'm sure we can do that. We just need to remember what everyone's proper colour is. Can any of you help Pocoyo? Why don't you shout out when Pocoyo gets it right? Go ahead, Pocoyo. Try out some colours. First, what colour is Pato? Pink?
No.
Blue?
No.
Yellow?
That's it!
Pato's yellow!
And let's see who else. Oh, yes, yes, Ellie. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what colour Ellie ought to be? Is it yellow?
No.
Blue?
No.
Pink.
She's pink.
Yes, she's pink, of course. Whew, I think that just about does it. What is it, Pato? What's wrong? Oh, dear. Pato's hat still isn't the right colour. Do you see, Pocoyo? Great work, Pocoyo, and great work, everyone. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye, see you soon.
Máquina de colores.
Bumbleberry Surprise. Hi, guys. What are you reading?
Recipe!
And have you found something tasty? Looks like you found the perfect snack. And how is it made? Oh, I see. We need bumbleberries, of course. What are bumbleberries? Ah, a special delicacy that can only be found in the amazing Bumbleberry Forest. That's better. I think he likes you, Pocoyo. Nina says the berries highest up are the sweetest for baking. They grow all over the forest. Maybe you should split the group in two to collect them faster. This seems a good place to start. The bumbleberries look excellent. Pocoyo, why did we come to the forest? It? What teamwork! See? Pocoyo has found the best berries while bouncing. you're ready to bake now. Good thing there's plenty of friends to taste this tremendous snack.
Look at Pato, he is yellow. He's as yellow as the sun. Just like potato chips or like a ripe lemon. Bright red, fire engines are red too. It's the color of Crazy Fred and the color of crabs, it's true. Nina likes wearing green and the nature's green, you know, like the leaves on the trees and the apples and the pears when they grow. Red and blue, green and yellow.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
But what's that you're doing? Following somebody's trails? I wonder who left those footprints. They're rather small. I think I know. They are exactly the same size as Pocoyo's feet. Can anyone help Pocoyo guess who made those footprints?
Pocoyo!
It's Pocoyo's feet!
They're quite right. Pocoyo, you're following your own footprints. What's that? Look, there are more footprints. And whoever left them isn't wearing shoes at all. In fact, I think they've got little paws instead of feet. Who left those prints? Do you know, Pocoyo? Well, did you leave those prints, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo guess whose prints those are?
A dog!
It's Lula!
Why, you're right! It was Lula! You see, sometimes we leave tracks or prints behind us, like when we walk on sand at the beach. Now those are very mysterious. Who or what do you suppose left those?
Round.
Yes, they are round.
Big.
You're right. It's big, too. Much bigger than your footprint, Pocoyo. Big, round feet. I wonder who on earth it could be. Pocoyo, do you know who could be leaving these tracks? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who has been making these big, round tracks?
Ellie!
You're right! It's Pocoyo's good friend, Ellie. Hello, Ellie! You certainly do have big feet, Ellie. Now here's someone who's leaving some very interesting footprints. Hello, Pato. Going for a swim? What prints are these?
Big!
Yes, whoever left these prints has great big feet, even bigger than Ellie's. And whoever it is has webbed feet. Whoever left those footprints, it certainly wasn't a boy, a dog, or an elephant, was it, Pocoyo? So who could it be?
What's that?
Oh no, Pocoyo. I don't think it could be a monster. Pocoyo? Pocoyo? If you just take a look... Pocoyo, I know it looks as though the monster is very close by, but really, there's no need to panic. Look, Pato, that's strange, isn't it? The prints are right behind you. See who left those scary-looking footprints, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose feet match these footprints?
Pato!
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 It was Pato all along, in his flippers, going for a swim. Hooray for Pocoyo! You solved the mystery of the great big monster. Good work. Bye-bye. See you soon. Thank you.
Red.
Pocoyo?
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
Duh.
Yes. I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out? A door to the sky? Now that's unusual. I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door!
Pato, there you are! Pocoyo is looking for you! Wait! Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him! Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again! Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him? Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh, Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato's!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato.
Hooray! You found him. What's that, Ellie? You're working on something. What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Rainbow? Rainbow! Rainbow, 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 rainbow! Red! Orange. Red.
Hi, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What are those things?
Paintbrush. Palette.
Oh, I see. You're painting. What a beautiful painting. Hi, Ellie. What are you doing? You're taking pictures. Terrific. Hello, baby bird and caterpillar. What are you doing? You're making a sculpture. Wonderful. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A camera? A paintbrush? Now, Pocoyo.
Palette. Bye.
Well, good night. Hello, Pato. Look, it's a museum. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A sculpture!
Right, a sculpture. You don't like it? Oh dear. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A painting!
It's Pocoyo's painting!
Painting!
You don't like the painting? Can you tell Pato what those are?
Pictures!
Pictures. You don't like the sculpture, the painting, or the pictures? Quack, quack.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a kangaroo!
A kangaroo. Pato, I think you hurt your friend's feelings. Well, maybe you can show them how to do it. What's that you say, Pato? It's too difficult? Ellie says your painting is wonderful, Pato. You're all talented. Hooray! Hi, Ellie. What's that? Oh, a new doll. It's beautiful. It's Pato and Pocoyo. They're painting. Ellie says you should paint her doll. It's perfect. It has a nose, eyes, two eyes, ears, two ears, and a mouth.
I love you.
Okay, time to paint.
The Martian Brothers Show.
Pencil. Crayons.
Crayons.
paintbrush.
A paintbrush.
Okay, Ellie wants to see your paintings. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a nose.
A nose. Right. Can you tell me what those are?
Eyes.
Two eyes.
Eyes. Poor Ellie. Can you tell me what that is?
A mouth.
Good, a mouth. What are those?
Ears.
Two ears.
Ears. Ellie doesn't look very happy.
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is... brown! Something brown. What can you find? See your pictures. A brown chest. A brown paintbrush. A brown door. Good! Keep searching for brown things. A brown suitcase. Perfect. A brown chair. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is? A brown teddy bear. Very good. Hooray for brown. Poor Ellie.
Oh, you're going to try again. What's this? It's a big painting of your doll.
I love you.
Wonderful!
If we have just a pair of eyes, it's not a face. If we have just a pair of ears, it's not a face. If we have just a giant nose, it's not a face. If we have just a giant mouth, it's not a face. But if we have two ears and just one nose, and if we also have two eyes and just one mouth, then we have all the things that make a face. All the things that make a face. We have all the things that make a face. But if we have two ears and just one nose, and if we also have two eyes and just one mouth, then we have all the things that make a face. All the things that make a face. We have all the things that make a face.
Hello, Bato. A paintbrush. You're painting. Great. Pocoyo has crayons. And you, Ellie? A pencil. Terrific. fruit. Ah, I see. You're painting a still life. Wonderful. Hello, baby bird. Can you tell baby bird what Ellie is holding?
A pencil.
That's right. A pencil. Ellie is drawing with a pencil. And what's that?
A paintbrush.
That's right. Pato has a paintbrush. And Pocoyo, what does he have?
Crayon!
He has a crayon!
Very good. Pocoyo has a crayon. Baby bird wants to be in the picture. Beautiful.
The Martian Brothers Show!
Notebook. Palette. Five strawberries. One. Good job, Pocoyo. Oh dear.
Hey.
What a beautiful drawing, Ellie. Oh no. Baby bird, it's not nice to eat the still life. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, spin! That's it! Spin around! Everyone spin! Spinning is fun! Fred says, giggle! Come on, let's giggle. That's it. Giggle. Giggling is fun. Fred says, walk. Walk. Everybody walk. Well done. Fred says, that's all. Now, baby bird, it's not that bad. What's this? Look at your friend's pictures. There's one in pencil, a lovely one in crayon, and a beautiful painting done with a paintbrush. It looks as if Baby Bird really likes your pictures. Hooray!
I like to paint
something nice, something beautiful. I paint with my friends, each of us in a different way. You can use the palette and the paintbrush, the pencil, or maybe you prefer the crayons.
Paintbrush, palette, pencil, crayons, notebook, backpack.
You can use the palette and the paintbrush, the pencil, or maybe you prefer the crayons.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Ellie's got a pot on her hand. Oh, I see. She's doing a painting. That's a very unusual way to paint. What's that?
Monkey?
You think you hear a monkey? Can any of you tell Pocoyo if that's really a monkey?
It's not a monkey.
No, it's baby bird.
That's right. It's not a monkey. It's baby bird. And look, he's doing a painting too.
Excellent.
Fred is going to do a painting too. What are you going to paint? Oh, you don't know yet. I see. Pato, aren't you going to paint a picture? Maybe you will and maybe you won't. I suppose Pato doesn't think painting is much fun. Aha! Time for the big exhibition. There's Baby Bird with the party food. Yummy, how lovely. Ah, and here's Ellie's painting. What do you think of it, Pocoyo?
Beautiful. Powerful.
Ah, this must be Baby Bird's painting. What's that, Pocoyo? You're trying to think of words that describe the painting. Ah, of course. Vibrant. Vigorous. Dynamic. Careful, Baby Bird, don't get too excited. Oh, here's Fred's very fine work. Pocoyo wants to know what it's supposed to be, Fred. I see. Yes, 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 of course. He says it's a scribble.
Oh.
Here's Sleepy Bird's painting. What do you think, Pocoyo?
Honest?
True.
Asleep.
Pato, you decided to do a painting after all. Can we see it? What? Pato! You painted that? There's more! My goodness! You have even more? Let's see them! You painted all these? They're amazing! Could you paint one for us now? Oh, come on, Pato. Everyone would love to watch you at work. Wouldn't you like to see Pato do a painting?
Yes! Go ahead, Pato!
You don't have the right materials. That's no problem. Here you go. A nice blank canvas. You're thirsty? There you go. All right, Pato, we're ready. Amaze us. Oh, dear. Pato, you didn't really paint those paintings, did you? Okay, here is what we're going to do. First, take those paintings back to where you got them from. Very good. Here's a nice blank canvas. Give it a try. All right, you don't like to paint. What do you like? Flowers! You're right, they are lovely, so why not paint them? No, but there's nothing to be afraid of. Look, Pocoyo's drawn a wonderful flower. Pato! You did it! You painted a painting! And it's a splendid one! That's fantastic! Now, aren't you glad you tried? Hooray for Pato! Hooray for trying something new! Bye-bye! See you soon!